Dear students, welcome to the science class. In the last class, we started with the new topic that is nothing but nutrition in the plants. And we also discussed about the nutrition in plants is going to happen by a process known as photosynthesis. Right, we discussed about the raw materials which are required for the photosynthesis process. That is nothing but carbon dioxide, water, sunlight, and presence of chlorophyll. They are going to make their own food. Because of that, they are known as autotrophs. The mode of nutrition is known as autotrophic nutrition. So, in today's class, we are going to see how actually they are going to make their own food. How actually they are making their own food. Now, if you remember the last class, what is the major food factory of the plants? What is the major food factory of the plants? It is leaves. It is nothing but leaves which are present on these plants are the major food factory of the plants. That is nothing but plants are going to prepare their food on leaves. Right? This is nothing but a simple diagram of leaf. It's not that good and it's not that accurate and it's not that beautiful. Which one is drawn by me? So they are trying to draw accurate diagrams. Right? Leaf. When you cut that leaf into cross section, when you cut that leaf in above layer, when you cut that leaf, when you see it in microscope, it looks like this. It looks like this. Why we should cut the leaf? We should came to know that we should know the where does actually the food is going to be prepared. How does the raw materials are going to enter the leaves? Right? When you cut those things, when you see this cross section of the leaf, it looks like this. It will be having the epidermis, endodermis. Epidermis is nothing but outer layer. Endodermis is nothing but inner layer. In that detail, it is not there for you. Just you remember this diagram so that it is easy to analyze the photosynthesis procedure. When you see that, it is the last class. If you remember, we discussed about the cells. Right? Every organ is made up of these cells. How cells look like? Cells look like bricks. They are the arrangement of the bricks. To build a building in the same manner, there will be arrangement of cells so that the organ is built. So that when you see that, it is the arrangement of cells which is going to make us an organ. The leaf is made of this cell. When you see the lower portion, this lower portion contains the tiny holes here. These tiny holes are nothing but the stoma. The tiny pores are nothing but the stoma, or we can call it as stomata. We can call it as stomata or stomata. Right? These tiny pores are nothing but the stomata. Beneath those things, there is a guard cells. These are cells which are guarding the stoma. Is nothing but guard cells. Right? Those are the guard cells. And these diagram is of stomata. Guard cells plus tiny pores together is known as stomata. This will be the stoma and this will be the guard cells. Together it will be known as stomata. And it is the opening of the stomata. It is the opening of the tiny pores. Right? Why the tiny pores are open here? Because so that the carbon dioxide which is present in the environment should enter the leave so that they can prepare their own food. So that is going to be open. That opening is nothing but stomata opening. Now next one, when we are going to see the procedures. Now already we discussed that raw materials are going to come from the sun. In the environment, carbon dioxide is going to be present. In the ground level, there will be water is going to be present. The last class only we seen that water is going to be absorbed by the roots. The same manner, sunlight is going to be absorbed by the leaves. On that leaves, chlorophyll will be present. In the same manner, carbon dioxide is going to pass through these tiny pores, that is nothing but stoma, into the leaves so that they are going to prepare their own food. Right, so that we are going to discuss one by one. Right, process of photosynthesis. Process of photosynthesis. process of photosynthesis which actually happens in the daytime. Right, it actually happens in the daytime. So that we can say that first condition, we will see that water will be absorbed by the roots in the same manner sunlight will be absorbed by the green pigment, that is nothing but chlorophyll. So that one by one we can see that water which is present in the soil is absorbed by the roots. I am going to show the schematic diagrams on this. I am going to show the flowchart on this so that you can easily remember those things. In the notes it will be in detail. In the notes which I am going to give in the PDF format, it will be in detail. You just remember this flowchart. Along with this flowchart, it will be easy to you to understand those things. It will be easy to you to remember those things. That is nothing but process of photosynthesis is nothing but water will be absorbed by the roots. In the same manner, sunlight will be absorbed by the what? Sunlight will be absorbed by the leaves. Why leaves? Every item, every raw material should lastly go to the leaves only so that they can prepare their own food. Last food factor, we know that it should go to the leaves. The water which is coming, it should go to the leaves. The sunlight is also going to the leaves. In the same manner, carbon dioxide will also be getting to the leaves so that every raw material should go there and there will be the process of the food formation by the plants. Right. Here in this case, water and sunlight both are absorbed by the roots and leaves. This water is going to transfer to the leaves. This water is going to transfer to the leaves by the vessels. Vessels are nothing but pipe-like structure which are present in the roots as well as stems as well as leaves. It will be pipe-like structure which is present in the roots, leaves and stem, so that they are going to pass the water from roots then to the stem then to the leaves. Right, vessels are nothing but pipe-like passage of water. Pipe-like passage of water which is present in the roots, stems as well as the leaves. Which is present in the roots, stems as well as leaves, which is going to pass the water from the ear to the leaves. In the same manner, sunlight is absorbed by the leaves. That is nothing but it contains chlorophyll, which is absorbed by the chlorophyll, which is present on the leaves. If you remember last class, chlorophyll is nothing but it is a green pigment which is responsible for the green color of the leaves. It may be present everywhere. It may be present on the leaves, it may be present on the stem, or it may be present on the stem or bark. In the maximum amount of chlorophyll will be present on the leaves only. Right? It is the major component, major pigment for the greenery of that leaves, greenery of the plants. Right? This sunlight is absorbed by the chlorophyll on the leaves, and water which is absorbed by the roots is transferred to the what? It is transferred to the leaves by the vessels. And now water and sunlight are both in the same condition. Water and sunlight are both present on the leaves. Right? When those both are present on the leaves, sunlight, in presence of sunlight, this water is going to be do a chemical reaction. There is going to be a chemical reaction happen. By that chemical reaction, when water gets into these gases, the water is going to go into the leaves. On that leaves, it is entering into the gas cells in presence of sunlight. When water enters into the gas cells, these gas cells starts to expand. When the gas cells expand, they will be going to make an opening of the stomata like this. Let this be the gas cells, they are closing like this. There is no opening in the hands. When water which is coming from the roads enter into these guard cells. These guard cells are going to be open. These guard cells are going to be opened like this. When these guard cells open, their carnivore starts to open it. When open, there is a space for the movement of the carbon dioxide. When this thing is open, the carbon dioxide is going to enter into the leaves. It is going to enter into the leaves. So that water when enters into the stomata, in this here case, the guard cells, or you can say that stomata opening happens. Stomata opens. Through that stomata, carbon dioxide will enter into the leaves. Or you can say that again. Through the leaves, carbon dioxide will enter. See one by one step. Roots, the water is going to come from the roots, it is going to get into the leaves. When water gets into the leaves, stomata starts to open. Stomata opens, carbon dioxide which is present in the environment, it enters into the leaves. Right? Now water is also present in the leaves. Carbon dioxide is also entered into the leaves. In the same manner, what? Sunlight is absorbed by the leaves. Therefore, at that point, using the sunlight, using the water and using the carbon dioxide in presence of chlorophyll and the chlorophyll, plants are going to prepare their own food. Plants are going to prepare their own food in form of the starch, in form of the carbohydrate, that is nothing but the starch. So there is the equation for that. I think this is clear. It is all about the photosynthesis. Right, what we required, all the components for that photosynthesis should enter into the leaves. So that the water is going to be absorbed by the roots in the same manner sunlight is going to absorb by the leaves. The water from the roots is going to get into the leaves by the vessels, which are nothing but pipe-like structures which are present on the stems, roots as well as leaves. When water enters into the leaves, it is going to enter into the stomata. It is going to enter into the guard cells of the stomata. When it enters, the guard cells starts to open it. The guard cells will be helped in the opening of that stomata. When that stomata opens, by this tiny pore, the carbon dioxide which is present in the environment, it starts to enter into the leaves. When it enters into the leaves, all the raw materials which are required by the plants are all at leaves. Carbon dioxide is also at leaves. Sunlight is also present in the leaves. In the same manner, the water is also present in the leaves. All together, using all those things, what plants are going to prepare their own food. Plants are going to prepare their own food at the leaves. For that reason, sunlight is being a resource of energy which is going to help us in the procedure of the preparation of the food of the plants. It is all about the photosynthesis. Generally, photosynthesis equation can be given as what all are present there? Carbon dioxide which is entering from the environment to the leaves from a tiny force which are opening because of the water when enters into the guard cells of the leaves. Plus water is also there. Carbon dioxide plus water in presence of sunlight, in presence of sunlight only the water and the carbon dioxide are going to act together to produce the food. The food is nothing but it is in the form of the carbohydrate. Along with that, it is going to release the carbon dioxide. It is going to release the oxygen. The tiny force which are present here is going to intake the carbon dioxide. They are going to prepare the food. At that food, the raw material which is going to be the product which is formed is one is carbohydrate, another one will be the oxygen, which is going to release. is by this tiny force for the utilization of the human being for the purpose of the breathing, for the purpose of the respiration which is coming from the plants. Right, this is all about the photosynthesis. I hope this is clear. The next class we are going to discuss further sections of this topic. Up to that point, just write the detail in the about photosynthesis, how it is actually occurring, so that in the next class we are going to further discussion on the further sections. So that up to that point, thank you, take care.